In Liverpool, the number of cases had risen from below 3 in 2007 to 11 in 2008.
Of course, what you're going to have is young men, especially young black boys, who are going to look at women in a certain negative way.
How come we're not caring about this?
I've come to meet youth worker Sheldon Thomas in Brixton, South London, where he works with young people.
Is this whole gang rape thing a black problem?
No, I don't think it is, but there is a disproportionate amount of young black boys involved in it. And that is why I am very concerned, because we've got a situation in our community that needs to be addressed. And I don't believe, in my opinion, that we in the community are addressing it.
Why not?
Many of us don't like to look in the mirror. The fact is, just like gang lifestyle and the violence that gangs bring, we didn't want to address it because we're too busy trying to blame somebody else for the problem. I believe that this situation of gang rape in our community is the same scenario, that it's difficult to address it because then people want to look to blame somebody, because, you know, you might have people wanting to blame, oh, it's mother's fault, or it's absent father's fault, or it's the media's fault. We need to put aside all of that, and we have to start dealing with some home truths. We've got a generation that look at sex as if it's nothing, and treating disrespecting women as if it's nothing. We've got women who have no confidence in themselves, young girls who think it's okay to sleep with one guy or two guys, or possibly three, or possibly all three at the same time, or being forced into doing things that they don't want to do, but feel that their peer pressure is pressuring them to do it. These guys are like 13 and 14 and 15, and their actual attitude towards young girls, towards sex, is mind-blowing, because it's actually leaving you with, where's their morals, where's their values?
Of course, it's a tiny percentage of black men who are involved in attacks. The attackers are often known to the victims. This girl saw a gang rape at a house party.
Have you ever witnessed any of the scenes where these girls are gang raped? Can you describe it to me?
I've only seen it once, which was at a party. I walked into the wrong room and there was just loads of boys, and the girl's tights were ripped up, like. She was bleeding as well, because I think she was a virgin, and they were just taking turns on her, basically. And they were all there just waiting, and she was like crying and everything. And then I didn't get involved yet, because I thought if I got involved, they're gonna turn on me. And because I don't know them, I just walked away and I didn't say nothing to no one.
In part two, I investigate how gang rape is being used as a form of punishment.
I was like really upset now, and I was saying, no, I'm not doing it. And he like hit me in my face, like punched me.
We've spent 4 months investigating gang rapes. Two facts stand out from looking at our cases. We found, firstly, a disproportionate number of black men were involved. And secondly, most of the cases occurred in London. Of the 29 cases that we tracked down involving three perpetrators or more, 20 of them took place in the Greater London area, one in Birmingham, one in Liverpool, and 7 in towns around the country. I want to understand the sexual attitudes of some young people in inner cities. So I've come to King's Cross in London to talk about sexual practices in general. These teenagers say it's common for boys to have a number of girls they can call on for sex, and that it's not unusual for a girl to have sex, particularly oral sex, with several young men at the same time.
Obviously, like, if you deal with a girl and you don't take her serious, then, like, obviously, you will bring people in, innit? And then every man will have a go. Like, but that, obviously, the girl has to be, like, obviously, they ain't doing it. Like, it's not a rape thing, but, like, obviously, like, if the girl want, some of the girls, like, they accept, they take it like that, innit? They don't really mind doing it.
If she's willing to do stuff without being your girlfriend, then you just call her a link, innit? Just because it's someone you can just phone them and link up with them, and you can just do what you want to do with them, innit?
What about emotion? What about respect?
Oh? We don't take that into consideration.
I grew up, you know, really having respect for women, but what are you explaining here? What are you telling me? It's shocking. It just shows that you have no respect for girls.
I do have respect for girls, but come on,
it's hard to explain. You can't say that.
If don't respect herself,
how are you going to respect her?
That's what I'm saying.
That's how you have to do it.
Is it true that the sort of girls that you're saying that don't respect themselves become the girls who, in some cases, boys pass around?
Yeah, basically. It's like, it's a lineup, innit?
A lineup.
It's a circle where every man gets their piece of the pie.
Hey, Gina!
When you say lineup, this girl, and how many boys will you pass them around? Yeah.
You ask her, like, boom, like, what? Is it just me, or can I bring my boys in, innit? Like, my brethren, innit? If she says you could bring your brethren, then you will find a location, you will find a bed, you will find a room. And you leave her in the room, innit? Simple, like. Yeah. And, like, obviously, it's not a thing like we're kidnapping her, saying you can't go home. It's not like that. Whenever she's ready to go home, she can go. We don't really care, yeah.
You hear about gang rapes. What do you think about guys who...
Rape.
Gang
rape. You see, guys who rape, here on my life, yeah, I think they should all burn, because that's just disgusting. You can't force a girl to do something she don't want to do.
I don't think it's always... the way it's portrayed, yeah, it's not always the boy's fault. Because, like, the girls, yeah... Like, they'll do something, and then when people find out, they want to change up the story to make them look innocent when they're letting off. That don't make no sense.
I don't like, you know what I don't like, yeah? I don't like girls, yeah? This is one set of girls I don't like, yeah? You see, when a girl, yeah, comes, for instance, and she's like a lineup girl, like a hoe, yeah? And she comes, yeah? And in her head, yeah, you already spoke to her on the phone, you told her how there's 7 boys, 8, 9, 10, or 11, whatever, yeah? How many boys there is, and they're saying, yeah, they're still coming, they're on it. And then when they get to the location, they do what they said they were going to do. Fair enough. But then when people start speaking about it, and then word goes around, then they want to say rape. That's one thing I can't take, man. That's annoying.
I ain't going to lie. I know boys that are raped, yeah. But it's like, it's 50-50.
I don't know what that's
don't make me a rapist. So I don't care, innit?
I know men that rape, so
I don't give a f***. I mean, I don't care. But, yeah, like, it's 50-50. Because the girls will just change it up. They'll do something, yeah? And then when they find out everyone in their estate knows what they've done, they'll be like, they forced me to do it. They'll chat shit and let someone go to jail for that. Come on, man. It's not always the boys that. It's half and half.
What about diseases?
That's why you strap up.
That's why you strap up, yeah? But obviously, if, for instance, the girl gave you a disease, yeah, then it's a different story again.
What happens?
If a girl gave me a disease, yeah, I knew for a fact I would batter her, innit?
Yeah, I'm not battering her, I'm going to get myself cured before I batter her.